Now let me see what is a JSX file. I hope in the last lesson I just let you confuse so much. So let me clear all the things. So JSX is nothing but it's called JavaScript XML file. Generally, JSX works like a combination of JavaScript and HTML tags. So here you can see there is a tag, your user defined tag, which is called app, which has been used here. This app tag. So let me explain how this works. So if I just go to the app.js file, here you can see it's almost the same HTML tags, the div, header, the image tag, the paragraph tag, which you can see. Then what's the difference? The difference is the things which you do here is almost the same HTML, but you get some advanced features here like conditional rendering, which we would see later in this course. But I'm just saying what are the things available here like conditional rendering. And the important thing here is you can create reusable components. So here, if I come back in the index.js file, here you can see. So here they have used the normal DOM. So that is the document.get element by ID, and the ID they have given the name as root. So where does this name come from? So this is denoting the div with a name root, which has been in the public index file. So here, if you just go down here, you can see the div with the ID name as root. So this is how the React works. So in generally in React, it uses a virtual DOM. So here inside this, whatever thing you do here, so you have to generate all the components and you have to use this in a single file. And here, because in the render, in the React DOM.render function, you can just give only one tag. So here also you can see they have enclosed this app tag inside a single tag. So that is a React.strict-mode tag. So this is how React works. So you can just give only one tag inside the render method, and then you have to mention the tag ID name where this entire virtual DOM has to be replaced. Because this is just a virtual DOM which allows you to work in the development mode. But if you are just taking your website to the next level, that is the production mode, you can't work with the virtual DOM. You have to move it to the general DOM structure. So that is why we have mentioned the document.get element by ID and the name root here. This is basically how the JSX works. So behind the scenes, so let me explain how the JSX file runs. So here you can see inside a JavaScript function, we have used the HTML tags. This is the complete JSX file. Let me explain how this works. Actually, this file gets compiled using a compiler called Babel. So React uses a Babel compiler to compile this entire thing using the virtual DOM and send it to the normal DOM structure and let it view in the page where the user can see. So let me show a small example. If I just delete all the things here inside it, and I'll just put a single h1 tag and mention as the same pretty simple thing, the hello world. And if I just save it, so this will generally compiles for re-renders and reruns for each time you save it. So here you can see I just got a normal problem here. So it's just a warning that I didn't never used it. So I can just remove this one. So the terminal compiling, let me save it again. Yes, now it has been compiled successfully. Now if I just go to the browser, you can see I got the single hello world, right? So now it's running on the localhost server, but this is a React app. Right now you made this h1 tag run through the React. So this is how the React works. It's pretty simple, right? So we can just delete all these files because we don't need these things now. So we can just delete the setup text, the service worker, the index.css file, app.test file. If you want, you can just delete the app.css file also, but I'll just stay with it. Now I'll just so here you can just see setup text, service worker index.css and app.test file. I'll just delete it. Yeah. Now you can see I got a error here, file to complete, because I have just deleted this file which has been used in the index file. So regarding this, we will just see in the next lesson.